This is Lawrence. He's my oldest fan. He's 85. He lives in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Recently, I flew in to spend the day with him. He insisted on picking me up at the airport in his blue Toyota Camry with over 100,000 miles on it. As Larry puts it, I've been driving since I was 13 years old. For those trying to do the math, that means he's been driving for 72 years. He safely whips that Camry around like it's a race car. He used to race cars and motorcycles, but that's a story for another day. Larry eats the same meals every day. For breakfast, it's fresh pineapple and frozen waffles. Lunch is pastries and coffee at Starbucks, and dinner is a frozen dinner. But today, we end up at Cracker Barrel for lunch. Larry holds doors with a smile. While we wait to be seated, Larry tells me that he spends a good 10 to 12 hours a day learning from videos online. Not only is he a photographer, he also took up shooting and editing video. He let me know he doesn't like old people because they are set in their ways. Larry, on the other hand, continues to learn. Over lunch, Larry tells me about his world travels for work. From Egypt to Iraq to China, he's been there, done that. He also told me he's done with flying. So if someone wants to see him, they need to go to Tulsa or be no more than an hour drive away. The conversation turned to how Larry met his late wife. He gave me the long, beautiful version, but I'll give you the short and sweet version, which sums it up. As soon as I saw her, I knew. Our next stop takes us to Starbucks, where everyone knows Larry's name. Larry spends an hour or two a day either reading, working on emails, or watching videos on his iPad while he's there. On this day, we talk. We talk about family, we talk about business, we talk about life. We also talk about Larry's photos that the Starbucks manager asked him to hang in the store. Starbucks seems to be Larry's hub for meeting and having conversations with random people, and thankfully, it's starting to get back to normal. We hop back into the race car for the 10-minute drive from Starbucks to Larry's apartment that he does in 8. When we arrive, I get the grand tour of his living room, gear room, office, and the corner that's used as a photo studio when needed. But currently, where the studio would be, is a small folding table with two chairs set up around a beautiful backgammon board. "Do you play backgammon?" Larry asks. "I don't, but I'd like to learn." With that, Larry's eyes lit up like a kid in a candy store. We sat at the table, and class was now in session. Dice rolling, checkers moving, lessons being learned. Larry's kicking my ass, yet I'm actually smiling. 1-0. 2-0, 3-0, 4-0, 5-0, Larry takes the first match easily. Just so you know, if this is the face you see on the other side of a backgammon board, you're in trouble. He proceeds to take the next 20 games as well. Now I will get my revenge, but it wasn't gonna be tonight. I've been up since 3:30 a.m., and something tells me that Larry wasn't going to be the one to call it a night first. But I was crashing, and it was time to head back to the hotel. Larry once again volunteers to give me a ride. He hops up, floats to the front door, where he uses the world's longest shoehorn to slip into his laceless sneakers. We pull up to the hotel and agree to meet in the lobby at 9 a.m. to head to breakfast. Like clockwork, Larry's waiting for me in the lobby, ready to go to our breakfast. It's time to trade in Larry's frozen waffles for some fresh Waffle House waffles. We eat, Larry drinks coffee, I take some photos, and we talk. Our time is starting to run short as I have a plane to catch. But with a few hours to burn, I ask Larry if he'd like to head to Starbucks to play some more backgammon. With a huge smile, Larry says, "Sure." He so happens to have a spare backgammon board in his trunk for occasions just like this. We take up residence for the next 2 hours on the big table in the middle of Starbucks and battle back and forth, roll after roll, until I eke out a 5-3 victory and get my revenge just before we pack up and head to the airport. In the car, we get to talking about the future. Larry tells me, I'm ready to go whenever. It's kind of a nice feeling, actually. Once my wife went, I was ready to go. But I'm going to make the best of every minute. Now, I'm thankful that I got to spend as many minutes as I did with Larry. Remember, everyone has a story. They don't need to be a celebrity, musician, athlete, or some tech billionaire to be interesting. All you need to do is take the time to say hello and then sit back and listen. Now, there's one more thing. If you ever find yourself passing through Owosso, Oklahoma, be sure to stop by the Starbucks off of Highway 169. There you might find a table set with a backgammon board, an open chair, and Larry waiting for you to roll the dice.